comes on Ben Saeed. A bit of an up and down match yesterday. Ahmed Deo. The libero today is Ahmed Abdellal for the Dutch coach Guido Vermeulen. Well, he shuffled the deck a little bit, bringing Ahmed Salah back in, getting him fresh after he missed out yesterday. It was about squad rotation, keeping players fresh, keeping players healthy. So Salah going to breathe as the starters get introduced, led out by Tetsuya Fukuzawa. There is Yuji Nishida, only 19 years old. Listen to the introduction for him. The center will be Masahiro Sekita. He's joined by Yuki Ishikawa. And the middles are Kentaro Takahashi and Taishi Onodera, with Tomohiro Yamamoto inserted back into the starting lineup by Yuichi Nakagaichi at the libero position. There was a huge cheer when Yuichi Nakagaichi's name was announced here. This is the squad he sends out. You have to say that's probably his first choice squad. Should be good enough to get the better of Egypt. But if Egypt get off to a fast start, you never know. Best of five sets, as ever, and it'll be Japan to get things underway. Masahiro Sekita sending down the first set on this five-setter. Here we go then. It's a nice take from Saeed. Sometimes good enough. Now, if the big power hits, you make the highlight reels. But sometimes you've just got to be tricky and finesse these things. But they adjusted so well yesterday to the Russian blocking that was such a problem for them early on. The Egyptian blocking, not a major weapon. So, nice pick up there. And so, kill from Yamamoto, Nishida, just about forces that one through. No, he doesn't. No, comes back. Almost rolled along the net, this one, didn't it? No, sent back. Abdallah Beki, along with Mohamed Dola, sent that back. Early win at the net there for Japan. Service as easy to take as that. Should be able to put it away. Kentaro Takahashi with the inside kill. Now Ishikawa is some server. Really nice take from Abdellal, the libero. That's Salah, can't find a winner there. Nice defensive work, and the job finished off beautifully by Ishikawa, drove through from the back attack. Well, it was his defensive work in the first place that helped set that attack point up. Beautiful execution, so he'll carry on serving. Skimmed away from Deo. Wonderful bit of football there from Abdallah Beki. Wonderful stuff. And then they get a block in as well. This is good stuff from Egypt. Nishida will go for another one. Now they can transition here. The block comes in from Japan. Overhead from Ahmed Saeed. You've got to feel sorry for Egypt there. They've done all the hard work. Nothing more spectacular than that from Abdallah. And then just when it looked like they were going to transition out, they get blocked. And then having been blocked once, they force the issue. And Ahmed Saeed just can't get a touch on that. Big point for Japan early in this one now. Where's that going? Back on first touch. Saeed. Nishida walks in. The Egyptian coach is prowling to sideline already here. Yeah, no surprise that he's taken a timeout.
We can play in the middle. Okay? Hey, come. We go on.
Taking the time out that early, it's not good news, and Peter Vermeulen knows his team's in trouble early here. A couple of misses from Ahmed Saeed haven't helped. No personnel changes for Vermeulen, not this early. Ishikawa is still at the service line. 5-2 here, looking to pour it on. It's not a great take either from Deo. Now, where's this going? Abdallah just has to swat it over. Japan can mount another challenge here. That's over on first touch. Japan keep the initiative here. The inside hit, good enough. Off the block and away. And Egypt in big trouble here early. Lovely rescue there from Ahmed Abdallah. It's a rearguard action that they're fighting here, and Japan finding a way through again. Takahashi straight down Main Street once more. Okay. We get more of Ishikawa, who varies it up. That's not a great take either. Really well played by Abdallah. Just took control of the situation there, the setter. This was hovering around the net, and he's just said, you know what, I'm getting rid of that before Kentaro Takahashi could grab hold of it. Side out Egypt. Side out Japan. Takahashi winning that one. Takahashi then serving. Sent a big one in there, didn't he? Abdallah had to make a lot of moves to get second touch. No winner there for Fukuzawa. Now, where's Abdallah going? This time. This time he sends it near the side. Ahmed Saeed makes no mistake this time. That's what he needed to get him charged up. A little glass behind him there. Where are you? Sends him back side. Nola running a bit of interference, then Saeed ripping through. The feeling he had to have that for his confidence. Picked up off the floor. They're getting a lot of inside hits here, Japan, early in this first set. They've got a lead at the first technical timeout, 8-4.
Especially when he's front of the net, because here, finish. He commits. extra.
The timeout. It's Yuji Nishida coming up next.
That's it.
Okay, touching it. Oh, snips out of the net and drops it. He puts so much topspin on those serves, but he will get his share of these. There's another one. They all just sat and watched it. Nobody had a chance of picking that up. So a clean ace, even if there was a bit of good fortune in it, for Nishida. Now Japan extending their lead here. And what's he going to do with this one? Only three back here for Egypt. Oh, that was vicious. Abdelal could not pick it up. A little bit surprised that they only had three back there. I think there's a fourth reinforcement coming back in. No, there isn't. Back-to-back aces from Yuji Nishida, who is a vicious server. They keep three back there. And Nishida sets that one too long. So hard to get a hat-trick of aces. It does happen. We've seen it on this court as recently as yesterday. But two in a row, you'll take that. Egypt are already chasing an awful lot of points on serve here early in this first set. Too easy again, it's getting a lot of inside points. The quality of the Egyptian serve is just not challenging service reception at all. Everything's being dropped back to the setter. If he doesn't have to move around too much, there's a very good chance he's going to hang one up there for the middle blocker to take it inside. And Takahashi and Onodera are gobbling those up at the moment for Japan. 11-5. There's another service reception. It's not great. Japan can grab a hold of this one as well. And Nishida. Ishikawa, that was. Wishing he'd have done a little bit better. Look for the touch. Couldn't find it. Side out. Salah then, the captain. Wonder why to have gone underneath that. Ishikawa. Gets the win this time. Against the block. Side out. Well, it's been quite a World Cup for the Ishikawa family. He's had a terrific campaign, and his sister, Yumi, broke through, the teenager, broke through into the women's senior squad. Looks like she's been playing there forever as well. In the Women's World Cup last month. Now, Taishi Onodera. That's not a great take again. Have to get a winner from there. Now, Sakita goes backside, Nishida rips it cross court. Once again, Egypt not helping themselves at all here. Their serves are not great. Their service reception is pretty shaky. And this is getting ugly early.
They serve like crazy. They serve like crazy. Put the ball high. All the sets we put to the net and we go pushing. Coach, well, if the center go out of the block, you have to push the ball to the net so we can win with pushing game. Yes? Hey, help each other. It's a difficult one. Help each other. Go.
Well, So Edouard Moulin has burned his two timeouts already here. We haven't even got to the second technical timeout. The early signs here for Egypt not encouraging. And that's again not a great take. Said can't get a winner. Rashida's driving through. Did he take anything off the block? You bet. That actually ended up in the crowd. Behind the baseline. Actually went about 12 rows back. This one just kept going and going and going. Well, the big hitters for Japan, Nishida and Ishikawa, living up to their pre-match billing here. Onodera will look to keep pouring it on. And service reception could be a lot better. An awful lot better. Nothing there for Salah. No, that's not going to work out for Fukuzawa either. Now, can they do something here? No, no play again. Another breakdown. They get a breakdown, though, Egypt. That was an overpass from Japan. A rare error from them. Off the mistake from Egypt, funnily enough. That just seemed to spook them on the other side. So Egypt will say, well, we'll take it. When you're this far behind, this early, you'll grab any lifeline you can get a hold of. Ahmed Deo serving at 7-14. First set. Nice take from Ishikawa. Back attack from Fukuzawa. It's perfect this time. They enjoyed that in the arena. They enjoyed it on the sideline. Yuichi Nakagaichi got the applause there for that one. Perfect execution. Again, the serve not asking questions. Japan are just demolishing these. Egypt struggling with their serves, with their service reception, and they're not finding blocks at the moment. Playing into Japan's strengths. That's a much better take. Oh, Said missed it. Just a miss. That's tough. The reception was great, the set, perfect. And he's just sent it to the beat. Impossible situation for Egypt here in this first set. Japan have just blown them off the court. They've already got to start preparing for what comes next. Just build some momentum. Try and make Japan grind out the points rather than just give them away. That's coming straight back from Sekita. So Said will have another go. That gets blocked. Third time works. Nice bit of variety there. Sayuri, the youngster, looked like he was going to swing through it and then just said, no, I can dip this. Here he goes, winding up. And then, no, the little push will work. Thank you. Look at that space. Very, very good backcourt defenders, the Japanese, but they couldn't get a pancake under that. So, nice play from Sayuri. His reward is to drop to the service line. Serving at 8-16. That's a good serve. It sneaks over on second touch. And the whistle goes. Anyway, there's some shenanigans at the net. Really good serve that. Won't go in. There's a but it might as well have been. Pretty comfortable take this time. Too good. Ishikawa. Covered that one really well. Both Ishikawa and Nishida love to swing through, but the more experience they get at this level, the more they mix it up. The more you mix it up, the better you become. Ishikawa, we've already seen what he can do with his serves. Said has got under it. Said will get third touch as well and get blocked back. There. Takahashi was right in the middle of that. Not sure if that was his touch that sent it back or not. There was a gang of three went up for that one, and I think it was the big number 16, Kentaro Takahashi, who sent that on its way. So Ishikawa will stay back there then. Specialist who's also got a big slide as well. It's not one of those guys you want to see coming off the bench. A switch up for Egypt sees Omar Tayson come in. Tayson has been a solid operator for Egypt as they start to change things up, and Saeed is the sat down as he was yesterday. That's a nice take. And then a miss across court. Salah. That opens up a double digit lead. Trailing by 10 points or more. That is confirmation that this is a thrashing. This first set couldn't be getting much worse. Side out as Nishida hits. They'll be happy about that. And now Nobu Fuji comes in. With Nishida checking out. So that's the setter coming in. So switching up his personnel here a lot. Yuichi Nakagaichi. At the business end of this first set. Otake. Only one player in the backcourt was the compact, powerful Tayson. He just dropped it in front of him. Beautiful, didn't swing through. Tayson was expecting, as indeed most Egyptians would have been expecting, a big power swing. He had a lot of baseline to cover all on his own. Just dropped in front of him. So Fukuzawa then. Nice take, really good take. Couple of touches. A miscue between setter and spiker. He's hanging it up there. He just got caught in two minds, saw the block. Just went, I've got to change this up. And Saudi ends up getting caught in two minds, which is the worst place to be in
this fast-paced game like this. So Fukuzawa sends that one in. That's nicely taken as well. And put away by Salah. Improved service reception here for Egypt. What a difference that makes. Just one serve away. It is Taishi Onodera serving for it. Oh, that's not a great. That's run really well. Abdallah's done really well because that was not great service reception. He's managed to claw that back, hanging out there for the big middle. Saoudi dealt with it. Here's the numbers then, 17-7 tells its own story. Egypt couldn't get the block going, so important when you're playing Japan. A couple of early aces really helped Japan just grab that one by the scruff of the neck. Egypt improved with their service reception. They'll have to show a continued improvement going forward from here. But they looked so confident with their hitting, didn't they? Nishida, Ishikawa, as ever, leading the way, but Fukuzawa chipping in, and a lot of inside work as well done by Japan in that first set. That's Philippe Blaine, the assistant coach, working with the squad there as well. It's a really terrific 1-2 punch partnership with Yuichi Nakagaichi, the man who sets the tone, the former player. The in-game adjustments coming from Blaine. These guys need some in-game adjustments, and it looks like they're trying to sort them out for themselves. Yeah. Ahmed Saeed returns from the bench at the start of the second set then for Egypt. He's back on the service line right now. Japan jumped out early in the first set. Egypt have got to make a more competitive start to this second set. Make it interesting. Saeed is a big server. Safe option there. It's just dropped on the line off the touch. Ishikawa making something out of not an awful lot there. Took a touch but dropped it on the line anyway. Saeed played it safe on serve. Now let's see if Egypt can maintain that. No, it hasn't. Took a touch. Was crawling on the floor, but not as far as the chair's concerned. And no call. Didn't catch the line either, so they haven't challenged it. They accepted that. So it's Egypt on the board. Ishikawa's made a mess of that. That's sent back by Mohamed Dola with interest. This is what Egypt wanted. That's just not a good move, that at all, from Ishikawa. Send those over. The overpass expected to get demolished by the middles. And Mohamed Dola duly obliged. Ishikawa does a better job this time. They'll send it over to Nishida. Side of Japan. At the start of this second set, I think he's aware of that. Watching very closely from behind the baseline, Yuji Nakagaichi. Looks like he's had to scramble around for that one. That's come back as well. Lovely dig there. And then there's a block. And that might not challenged. Quite a conversation going on here. Asking. Has that been withdrawn? Looks like play is going to resume. Gambling has been cancelled. So Japan. Takahashi picked up off the floor. What a good serve that was. That has to be good. Salute and rip that.
Okay, Ale, come on.
Japan need to be shaken out of this. Let's see what they do off that timeout. Sala sends that serve in. Nishida. That's a very nice pickup from Raider. The libero. Nishida lands another goal. The cross court is too good for Sala. Drops in front of it. A much needed side out for Japan. Possibly a little bit of a sense of complacency had just crept into Japan's play after that first set had been so easy for them, but Yuichi Nakagaichi and Philippe Blain between them, I think, made their point during that timeout. That's a sizzler from Nishida. Just push it up in the air and hope for the best here from Egypt. Sakita will get that. That's a serve right there. Anadira takes that. One of those quick sets. Those are points you should win. This is not exactly a surprise to see that happening. They've done well just to keep it alive, Egypt, but their big lead just by playing hard. And then inside out, Nishida. Another big one. Got the big one as well. Abdelal has put that up in the air. Deo. Oh, Deo has really hit well since getting introduced. Confident look about Ahmed Deo, 24-year-old, just demolished that one. Two back there. He's dropped it between the two of them. Absolutely no way that was coming back. Very nice play. Let's see what he can do with serve. Better look about Egypt with Deo. In this kind of move. In that kind of move, Japan. Get himself right back into it. Fukuzawa then with serve. That's an easy take. And the cross court winner is not there. Nishida made sure of that. And Nishikawa runs it off the block. Japan building momentum. Tucked into the slipstream here. Again, good defensive work. Three to beat in the block. Took it through the outstretched arms of Abdallah Bakita. Almost closed this gap here. Gaichi will be making sure that his players stay on message here. Oh, a message of its own from Ahmed Saeed. Absolutely ripped that one, didn't he? I'll take Egypt to the first technical timeout. With some momentum. Those don't come back. It'll be Abdelrahman Sayoudi to serve at 8-6. Egypt. That's a pretty safe line, but what he deserved. Another one of those quick takes inside and put away by Taishi Onodira. They have to push more with their serves, Egypt, because Japan are just gobbling these up and swatting them away effortlessly. Takahashi Onodera getting too many freebies. Change up here with Dola coming out. Close coming in. As Egypt trying to hold on to that lead that they established early in this one. Onodera with service. Not a great take again. That was too good. I rather think that Ishikawa got in the way of Onodera there. Completely blindsided him. He raced over. And Onodera just literally lost the flight of the ball. So Egypt riding their luck a little bit. Gala with serve. No stopping that one. Quick side out. This lead. Japan might have clawed a lot of it back, but they're still holding on to it here. It'll be set back side, and Yoshida makes a mess of that. That's a point on serve for Egypt. And that's a miscue. Pure and simple. Looked like he wasn't expecting that, because so many have been going straight down the middle. Will serve again. They send it the other side. That's going to be a good count. Rondao's a winner for Tatsuya Fukuzawa. That will send Takahashi back to serve. Still Japan chase. A couple of points to find now. Side out. Not too concerned here, does he? But what a far, far more competitive second set. Certainly Japan have been doing all the chasing. No point have they led here. Song slide on past the baseline there. Salah wasn't holding back on that one. Ishida talk about not holding back, but again, a really much improved service taken. Sent down. He needs to impress. But again, a really good take. Their service reception is night and day compared to what we saw in that first set. Egypt so much better. Matteo's been hitting winners all over the court in this second set. Yamamoto gets underneath that. That's clever. Egypt won't mind the side-out battle. They're the team with the lead. Japan has got to find something a bit different here. Got a block to deal with, so just decided to take plenty of heat out of that one. Vastly experienced for Kuzawa. He's now going to try and claw a point back here on serve. It's easy take, easy pull. You cannot recognize Egypt from one set to another in terms of their service reception. It's like watching a completely different team. This is Saoudi back there now. We're going to try and take Egypt to a 4-point lead into the technical timeout. Sakita sends that backside and Ishida gets nothing but net there. I don't think that was a block, that was nothing but net. And I think if Japan thought all they were going to do was just having to keep playing and they get this back, well, they better get themselves out of that mindset, because Egypt have led right from the get-go here.
They hear it.
There's no stopping them at the moment.
Make mistake. Hey, guys. Yes, I make the 5 big.
Take at all. From Ishikawa. Makes a complete mess of the swing as well. And that might just be too much for Japan to claw back here. And he's going to change things up, and Ishikawa's going to sit down. It was a very poor point from Yuki Ishikawa. First touch was poor, and the swing was even worse. So he's out. Yanagida comes in. Even if they side out here, Japan now need 4 points on serve. Well, it's tough to see how they can get this back. That's Ishida. Affecting the first part of the equation. Side out. Next up in the rotation is Taiji Onodera. Not one of their big power servers. Looking to side out here, that is for sure. Egypt. Yeah, that's a pretty good take. That'll be sent backside. Oh, it's come back. Nishida's managed to get it back. And that's blocked as well. They'll have to win it again here, Egypt. Yeah. Just kept the momentum going. Now Japan in a full defensive stretch. Into the three attempts, and they got through there, and Ahmed Saeed enjoyed that one. Go, 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 go. too bothered about what's happening elsewhere, but what has happened elsewhere is the United States have just managed to survive a 5-7 against Canada. Had they lost that, Japan with a win here could have moved into a bronze medal position, so that didn't quite work out for them. And this second set isn't quite working out for them. They need 4 points on serve. Sekita looks for the first of them. Again, another really good take. And there's the result. Good service reception. Everything followed on from there. Egypt utterly unrecognizable. From the team that barely bothered to show up for the first set. Saeed then serving at 19-14. Playing a little bit more conservative with their serves. Rashida can't get a winner there. Oh, we'll take this on second touch. Just missed, but didn't take a touch on the way through. They all reacted as if they did. Now, Abdallah Bekin decided he would take that one early. It went long. That was the call. But they want that reviewed. And that's why they wanted it reviewed. Surely no way back into this one now for Japan. Otake will come in. Both Nishida and Ishikawa currently in the bullpen. As Yuichi Nakagaishi more or less concedes this second set right there. But the gap has just got wider and wider. This set has gone off. Since the second technical timeout, Egypt have looked really solid and secure. This is a big, big, big deficit. Japan have got a pull back. It would take an Egyptian collapse for that to happen, you would think. Yamagita sends the first one over. And it's a good service reception. But they'll get a piece of this, Japan. No winner there for Fukuzawa. Dayo can't find anything there, he's always backpedaling. Who can get a good swing here? Can Otake? No. No, it was not a good position there for Issei Otake. Couldn't get anything on it at all. Just had to stretch for a little touch. And the block was just all over it, smothered it. So it's Mosen then. 21-15. Side out. Oh, it's not good. Look at that. Abdallah with a wonderful pickup. And then a nice winner down the line from Salah. Wow. This really is. It's not so much that they're losing this set, Japan, but they're not building any kind of traction at all. If anything, they're starting to look really shaky. That was a point they should have won every time.
We take the time for make the easy things. Huh? High ball, precise. This is control here. You have to control. And take the time, okay? End of the set, you make side out and you grow up. You grow up.
Okay, come on.
And stays on serve then. As a block comes in, Sayuri wiping out his fellow number five, Fukuzawa. This is as poorly played set as Japan have given us in this World Cup. Absolutely taken out of it. Knows himself, finally goes long. We're going to see some changes here again. Those creative servers, Haku Lee. Destroyer with devastating pace. And he's one of those servers that seems to be able to get the ball to do things. Seems to get this ball to do an awful lot here. Japan needs 7 points. And we'll get a chance at something here. Fujisawa's flopped out of it again. Oh my goodness me. Sayuri was in the middle of that again. Whether it was Sayuri or whether it was Salah, doesn't matter. It's a point Egypt. Japan's big weakness against the block is starting to manifest itself here in a big way. They got away with that one. Just. But it's still a big concern here. Japan, the way the blocking style is coming to play. What about that? Absolutely ripped through from Ahmed Saeed. He's playing as if he's got some kind of grudge going here. Lovely fake. Look at that. So we're at set point. Too long. Itake goes long, and that's the end of that. Well, who would have seen that coming half an hour ago? As poor as Egypt were in that first set, they were absolutely terrific in the second set. Once they jumped out to the early lead, Japan just played as if, well, we'll get this back. They never gave themselves a chance to get back into it. They didn't earn the right. Hido Babulin's team stayed right on them. Made huge improvements on their serve and on service reception. Absolutely dominated that second set. Will Evelyn, what a piece. Then Egypt winning the battle of the attack hits, getting a couple of block points in there later on as well. Look at that for Japan, no blocks, no aces. Very, very different story. We know Japan can do better. We saw Egypt make a huge improvement right across the board. Set one to set two. Just to see how Japan responds to that. The best thing you can say about a set like that is forget all about it, move on. But Egypt will want to carry that momentum and that dominance into this third set too. Nicely balanced this one then. See how this third set plays out then. We've seen from the first two sets, you get off to a fast start, but these two, there's every chance you can maintain that momentum. It was all Japan early in the first set. Egypt never got around at all. 6-2 early to Egypt in the second set. Japan never threatened. And Egypt have got onto this one as well. Abdallah sends that far side, and that's ripped down. Absolutely destroyed. Wow, this is a fast start. This is really good stuff from Egypt here. They've got some momentum now. Once again, Deo hitting so well. Ishikawa is having a really tough time. Fukuzawa, no, nothing for him either. Away it goes, and that's another big win, and Deo's ripped another one. This is going to be a serious cause of concern. It really is. They just haven't shown up for the first set either, Japan.
That they can win this match, they will fight on the ball. They are pretty straightforward. Huh? On the perception, they are working on the ball. You have to find efficiency on the side because you need to open to be efficient side out. Okay? Come on. Go!
Thank you. Egypt haven't put themselves in this position by accident. And they may have some very serious decisions to make. Philippe Blaine and Yuiki Nakagaichi, because they've begun to hit fire and well. That was much needed. That's one of the guys who's been this far, Nishikawa, coming up with this one. Putting Japan on the board here. Fukuzawa up next. They're resisting the changes up until now, Japan, but that's not a good take. Nakara did really well. The set back is for Onodera. Now, that wasn't a good service reception for Egypt. They've been punished for it. There was no block even to beat there for Onodera. Egypt rather all over the place on that point. They need to tighten it back up again here. As Fukuzawa looks to lock and load. Nice take from Saeed. The block is there, but they can't keep it in play. That's another point, Egypt. Fukuzawa rips through there. Onodera now will serve at 3-5. Bell will send it over. The big hit and Saeed doesn't come up with it all this time. Ishikawa. Amadeo just stepped in. He just stepped in and that vacated the space. Here goes 23, he's moved in. And that's what they're saying to him.
Okay.
Oh, they just judged that defensively there. And Japan are able to start firing a little bit now. Onodera looks to try and level it up here. There's a block, where's that going? Out. Side out. Swing there from Salah. Oh my goodness me, that's gone. That's out of there. Beauty of an ace. Oh, Salah absolutely ripped that one. Really just to fade away quietly here, do they, Egypt? Salah absolutely delivered that. Seen that one too long. He was the top scorer in the World Cup of 4 years ago, Ahmed Salah. Masahiro Sekita. Continue to repair the damage here. Nice take. Ahmed Saeed saying, you want to stop this? Good luck. That's Egypt on the first technical timeout. And this is the definition of full flow right there.
If we have two blocks here, there's Salah and Abdallah Arian. So four, you have to defense here because they go for this shot. Yes, not come inside because we are inside.
We doesn't make three blocks with them.
No, three blocks. No, but he will also close the last one.
شلوا وهدوا علينا
ماشي لا 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 مشاكل ها نكمل كده حاجه بعد
التركيز يا رجاله يلا
So, let's see what happens after the technical timeout with Ahmed Deo back to serve for Egypt. Looking to maintain their lead here in this third set. Early days, promising signs for Khida Mamoulin's side. Taken by Ishikawa, who will get third touch as well. That's come back though, Abdallah picked that up. And set it down the middle instead. Takahashi lowers the boom on that one. Those inside hits have been there for Japan right from the get-go. With both Nishida and in particular Ishikawa having their issues on the outside. Must be a temptation for Japan to just start funneling some hits down the middle again. Ishikawa. And it's been picked up. And taking a touch on the way through Saeed with another big hit. Confidence player Ahmed Saeed, and his confidence looks sky high at the moment. Saoudi then going to drop back to serve. Egypt remaining solid here through the early going of this third set. Up until running into Italy and Poland here in Hiroshima, they picked up at least one set in every match they played. As that one comes back, inside Takahashi. So Egypt are certainly no mugs. Japan did come into this one just looking at a team that lost five in a row and were there for the taking. They've been knocked out of that complacency, haven't they? Again, confirmation, the inside takes are there seemingly all day long for Japan. Takahashi. And so at 7-9. Ooh, he's made a mess of that one, Saeed. This is just hoist and hope time. Hang it up there. Japan should put this one to bed. Sakita will send it inside. Ishikawa drills it. Saeed is putting his hand up while the team huddle there on the other side. Saeed puts his hand up to acknowledge the problem which came when he mishandled serve there. So Japan with a point back. Still chasing. Takahashi getting ready. A little ripple of excitement rolls around the arena. That's a much better take. Really good take. As easy a bit away as you'll ever find there. Bosun just had to jump and swing. Simple as that. All on the quality of service reception. The setter did not move. The setter has moved now. He's moved to the service line. Abdallah. Sends this one in. Picked up by Takahashi, who can't get a winner there. That's terrific work by Raider. Now, can they pick this one up here? They just about get something. Oh, wonderful work there from Fukuzawa. They were at full stretch. That's a very Japan-esque point. That was absolutely brilliant at the back end there from Mohamed Raider. In the end, it's all in vain. Now, Abdallah's not happy about something. He and Ahmed Salah, the captain, have had a word with the second referee about something and have been sent back onto court. Got to keep their focus here, Egypt. They still have a lead here. Although it is Nishida up next. Oh, it's an ace! It's amazing how quickly momentum can spin around. Two really big points back-to-back for Japan there. Khida Mamoulin recognises that this has changed again. Calls a timeout, just needs to settle his players back down.
Play against them, we are better, we are better, we are better. Play against Japan, not anybody else. Look yourself. shadow from the referee. Fight your pen, fight your pen. Come on.
That is exactly what Peter Vermeulen had to say. It's the right thing to say. But allowed themselves just to be upset by a call that they didn't get. They're really in this match, and they need to keep their heads in the game here. As for Japan, well, they've finally got a bit of momentum. They spent all of the second set chasing in vain. They've been chasing for most of this set. Well, now they're level. On here at 10-all, Nishida with serve. It's a beauty. Deo's got that though. Really nice, and then Sala rips one down the line. Beautiful execution. Great take from Deo. And if there's any doubt about where he was mentally, Ahmed Sala has erased those doubts with that ripper down the line. Saeed then will serve. That's an easy take. Deo puts it away. Japan will gobble these up all night long. Fukuzawa. It's a sneaky one. Just about picked up off the floor. Deo can't get a win of this time. Where does Sakita go? Inside. Yoramakira continues to feast. Egypt just can't handle these inside hits at all. In front here. Side out, we'll see Egypt level. Ooh, that's a tough take. Did really well there, Abdallah. So too did Mohsen with the put away, because that was a tough one. No margin for error here. Abdallah had to just hang that up there and hope for the best. So Mohsen following through, executing. So we stay level. There's another one. Mystery to this for Japan. Monadiro will now go back to the service line. Should be put away. Goodness, goodness. Well, that could be the break that Japan needs. Saeed with a big, big swing there. Can't take anything. Yeah, the youngster just saying, yeah, I know, that's on me. Everybody has a miss once in a while, which is true. They do. Onodera. This is important, though, for Egypt. Got a side out here. Oh, that helps. There for Ishikawa. Oh! tough take on the other side there for Amadeo, was it? Just like that, Egypt back level. Well, we had Takahashi to beat. Salah, big server for Egypt. I'm very happy about that. Here's a switch up. Hisham Uwais will come in along with Hossam Abdallah, the backup setter. Hisham, we've seen in the past, a big, big hitter. So Abdallah, Benkeet, and Ahmed Salah will sit now. Kido Vermeulen freshens it all up. Sekita floats one in. Hello, here's trouble. Not exactly what it deserved. The overpass punished. I'm not sure if Egypt have wanted to challenge here. We are at the technical timeout, and that's what is being asked of Kido Vermeulen. Are you challenging something? If not, get your players back down to the sideline. Wanted to challenge, I think, but that was good. No question, that was going to get overturned. Japan finally building some heat here.
Now, quick, they start to be.
Okay.
After you come back, you see. When you play, you come back.
Hey, do you have a
your job is to be aggressive. Don't think about four girls and that. Just appreciate that person. And you will just touch it.
This third set, and Egypt regroup, bounce back. Sekita sends a big one in. Ahmed Saeed taking that one so high on the pipe attack. They all converged on it, but nobody could get anywhere near a dig on that one. The Japan back court. Deo then. Oh dear, no. Rather lost that in flight. I think the rule of the mind. Too much. At least he's going for his serves. Safe isn't going to win too many service points in this match. Ishikawa certainly didn't play it safe there. Slipped on the backside and just taking a touch. Shanky Weiss. Stubbornly refusing to go anywhere here. brilliantly. Really good defensive work again from Egypt. Nishida's going to have to win it again. Absolutely ripped that cross court. He didn't have much margin for error here. Didn't hold back at all, just ripped it. Has to catch the inside of the line, and it did. Doesn't matter how many cross-court defenders you got covering that. When it's that good, you are not stopping it. There's Takahashi then. Egypt must side out. They're the team that's chasing. Don't have to worry about that one. So Abdallah and Salah will come back in. They have to keep siding out. Nishida. This is a danger moment for Egypt. Nice take from Abdellal. The push there from Saeed. No play there for Sakita at all. Saeed can't get a winner there either. Sakita will hoist that one up there and hope. Fukuzawa just has to dink it. Here he comes again. Saeed gets there. Not going to be denied, was it? Had to just keep grinding and grinding there. Ahmed Saeed, it took him three goes to breach Japan defences, but he stuck to it. And eventually got his reward. That's a big side out for Egypt. Yeah, Saeed. Sending the soft serve, too soft. A change up here for Japan. Sakita will come in. Excuse me, not Sakita. It's Yanagida coming in for Fukuzawa. And it's Taysom who will re-enter the frame. Saeed earned the breather. He'll check out. He's earned a couple of minutes on the bench here. Saeed, that's smart from Kido Vermeulen. He's put in a very, very heavy shift here recently. Saeed needs a break. Yanagida sends that one way too deep. So the side-out battle continues, and it's getting pretty tense now. That gamble backfired. Yanagida couldn't conjure anything up. Mohsen will go back now to serve for Egypt. Get in front here at the moment. They've been forced to play catch up. He's a wobbler. Nishida rips it back. The tension continues to build. Service reception good, backside set, terrific. Nishida's swing, perfect. The target coming in for Sakita. They're looking for a block right here, Japan. Onavira. Back to serve at 21. 20. Point on serve here. The set could be theirs. Nice take, soft serve, it has to be served, and that's sent back in no-nonsense manner. Saeed missed an early one, wasn't going to miss that one, was he? So that'll bring Sakita back. His substitutions for Japan not working at all. Egypt have stuck close. Now, Abdel Hamid Salah, and his dangerous weapon of a serve coming up next. Can they get in front here? That's coming back. Abdallah's blocked, but it goes out. There's the breakthrough Egypt have been waiting and waiting for. Now they've got Japan chasing. Japan have to take the time out as well. Really well played set this for Egypt. Can they push on from here?
Stop deep. Remove everyone here. After those inside, I'm ready for this.
Salah serve. They've been front running Japan. Now they're chasing. Now all the pressure is on them to side out. Huge moment in this third set right here. Salah sends a soft one and it's an ace. It's a beauty. Absolutely brilliant from Ahmed Salah. Nobody expected that. He's winding it up. And he's just taken everything off it and finds a huge landing area there. That is a stunning moment in this match. Ahmed Salah has conjured up a gem of an ace to put Egypt on the brink of a 2-1 lead here. Played it soft again. Right, got red this time and moves the ball away. Smash it down the line. But Japan really are now playing catch-up and they've got not much time to do it either. Egypt side out here, they're at set point. Sakita came up with a gem of an ace himself last night. Haven't seen much of his serve as a weapon in this match. If he's saving anything up, now might be the time to produce it. What's he got? It's picked up nicely, a really nice take. Now the block's there, and brilliant. Ishikawa punches that away, takes it early. It's going to be a challenge here. Then there's a net touch. Vermeulen hoping that there's something here. You see the net twitch, and you're not sure why it's twitched, and the thing's gone against you. Throw the challenge flag down. See if you've got anything. Did that net move is the first question. Presumably it must have done, otherwise Vermeulen wouldn't be challenging this. It's a big moment there. Here's another big moment. Which way is this challenge going to go? Nothing there, it's just a touch from the ball. That's why the net move. That's worth a challenge. You've got to challenge that. Get it looked at. So, they get their point back. They're still chasing here, Japan. They're not out of this yet. Egypt side out, they'll be serving for the set. But they're back on turns. Sakita has conjured one up. But Egypt did exactly what Salah did. Oh, that's incredible. Absolutely incredible. Now it's Egypt have to call a timeout as Japan moves to set point.
Guys, there is only one team we play against Japan, not against each other. Focus on reception. Yes, let's just play our game. Come on, come on. Our game.
materially that doesn't change much either, except it does now have Japan front running. This has to be side out from Egypt. Well, the set's gone. Egypt now doing all the chasing. They have no safety net. Sekita serving for this third set. Sends in the deep one. That is going to be dispatched, set back, but still alive. Ooh. Takahashi must have thought he'd won it. And then a brilliant block the other side, and Ishikawa does rip it in. What a finish to that third set. Wow. You won't see much more drama than that. Two big, big blocks on that last point. First one way, then the other. And then Ishikawa rips one cross-court. Finally, this third set is over. Japan rallied from a very, very dangerous position there. A really strong finish. Egypt so close to taking that third set. But it's Japan who take it. Real drama there in the last 6 or 8 points of that one. They're still looking really unhappy there, the Egyptian players. And Abdallah, their setter, looks really distraught. Just being calmed down by his teammates at the moment. The numbers then from that gripping third set. Five aces. It was the last two that were so special. The one from Salah that was so clever. And then the response from Sekita that was every bit as clever as well. Not a single block point in that third set. Despite plenty of blocks, just on the very last point there. No actual block points. Interesting. Now, very interesting going into this fourth set to see how Egypt regroup mentally. They had that set where they wanted it. Japan found another level right at the death. Wonderful entertainment. Friday night crowd in Hiroshima. Well, the sold-out signs were up. Anybody coming in, hoping to get in here tonight, good luck. No tickets. Now, let's see how Egypt respond. The first few points will tell us a lot about their mental state. And Abdallah Bekit there. Setter, who looks so unhappy at the end of that third set, will get this fourth set underway. He won't be very happy at what's just happened there as Taishi Onodera puts Japan on the board. Nice take, comfortable set, easy inside, good away. Japan have been executing those very well all match. Nishida, the big server. Serves up an ace! this. Nice fell at his feet, didn't it? Mateo's been doing a nice job on service reception. Couldn't react to that one. So, quick out of the blocks here, Japan. Carrying on that momentum that they generated at the end of set three into set four here. That one. There's no danger to anybody. Nevertheless, the ace from Nishida gives Japan the early initiative here. Very, very early initiative. Sakita knew where his teenage terror was, flying through on the backside. All he had to do was throw it up there for him. Nishida did the rest. Side out. Fukuzawa then. We mustn't let this gap grow anymore here. Rob's one off the block there. Sakita, I think, just caught an eye full of this. Take a look and see what's happened here. Yeah, just got a faceful there. It's happened to him yesterday. He really is in the wars. Shaking that off. Dola then with serve. Yamamoto picks that up pretty comfortably. Driving through on the pipe attack, but the net court has really slowed that down. Oh. That's Ahmed Salah again. That's Japan's lead just gone. Absolutely super cross court that. No time to just set, aim, pull the trigger, fire. Dola then stays on serve. 3-3. Onodera with serve, it's picked up, sent on its way. Most of them, will rip through. Off a quick set inside, and they've been on the receiving end of a lot of those. Egypt, so they'll be very happy to send them back with interest as well. We stay level here, Egypt looking to take this into a tiebreaker. Sakita, that magical serve of his, effectively a set winner at the end of that third set. Goes for the big one this time. Saeed picks that up. Saeed goes for a really big one, but his weight would be over him back. That's an understatement. So Egypt forced to chase again. See what Sakita can find here. It's a pretty safe one. Should get punished. Saeed ripping through that one. Yeah. And that's bringing some heat. Between them. One attack hits, the two big middles. I think every single one of them has come like that. Ishikawa with the net skimmer didn't do him any favours. Actually, Saeed demolishes that. Yeah, he doesn't have an ace, Ishikawa, to his name in this match. The sharpshooter in crime, Nishida, has four. Salah with three. Technical timeout with a narrow lead. It's close. Close is good enough, though.
18.
Takahashi then to serve. Stepped in front there. It's the right decision. Masakita's picked that up. Nishida with a chance. And Bayo's back there again. This is going to come over on first touch. Sakita hangs one up there. Dispatched by Futsawa. Far side. That's another big, big moment, you feel, in this match. That's Japan with a little bit of wiggle room here now as Rashaan Atiya will come in. Rashaan looking to bring a bit of extra energy to Egypt, who are just starting to wilt here. Takahashi. Oh, it's another good serve. Abdallah was struggling. He was reaching for it. It's come back on first touch. And that has to happen. You have to bury it. So Fukuzawa with back-to-back kills. Might be just sending Egypt on their way. Much better take this time. Saeed's got work to do there. Made that really easy. That was a beauty. Side out essential. Job. Really nice pickup. Now the blocks there, though. To Zala, has another go. No problem there for that one. Side out. Japan starting to look irresistible here. This really is hang-on tight time for Egypt. This has got to be side out, and this is the danger server. Yuji Nishida looking for ace number five here. Not going to get it like that. He's disappointed, but he is an aggressive server, so of course you're going to get net serves and long serves. Egypt happy enough about that. Saeed. Someone of his in. Yamamoto takes that nicely. Nishida rips one off the block. Dayo was there with the block, and he couldn't control that. That was travelling. This is full throttle from young Nishida. But if you don't catch that one flush, it's going to go off at a crazy angle, as it did there. And Japan keeping the pressure on. Fukuzawa, who's back-to-back points, broke this fourth set wide open, serves up an ace. Dropped it in front of Ahmed Saeed. Egypt had to call a timeout, but Peter Vermeulen must know. This is almost over now. What a difference he's made here in this fourth set.
Guys, yes, Peter, you take all the shots. You are ready for that? Because we have to play the fight. Yes? You go quick, and you play quick with five behind them, okay? Here, stay A2 with the guy, go for the opposite, there's no second ball set, yeah? So you don't jump with set. Hey, guys, stay together and work it out ball by ball. Believe in yourself, tell you are the best, tell you are the best. Go, go, go.
Opposite, remember, with the ball is fast, don't try to reach here. Cattle inside.
You go in
six? Yes, yes, yes. I will take it.
Tetsuya Fukuzawa will drop back to continue serve here. Absolutely essential Egypt side out from now. Floated that one inside to pick that up. And it's dropped in on first touch. That's a terrible service reception. And even worse on the Japanese side. They all sort of watched it come over the net. You don't see many of those. Position, you'll take whatever you can get. Rashard with serve. We've kept this alive somehow. Abdallah has to go for the big swing there, and that was quite a swing. That's a center with a swing on him. Fukuzawa just sends that off. Look at this. Where's that ball going to go? Watch out in the crowd. This one's coming your way. What about that? From Abdallah. Sakita will send it over to Ishikawa. Side out. That's just what was needed there. Nishida and Ishikawa have been churning the points out here, as per usual for Japan. Onodera with serve, which got exactly what he deserved. Mosin will rip that one away. Another inside take. Can't stop those. Starting a fight back. There's Sauer on serve, and we know what he can do. Rebound that on the other side of the net. Never got off the ground. All changes. For Egypt, Hisham. Hossam Abdallah coming in. Abdallah Bekit sits down, so a switch of setter. Ahmed Salah also getting a breather here. As Egypt look to side out here, then work on picking up those 2 points they need on serve. Sakita with another one of his clever serves, and a block! Ishikawa! Beautiful block here to send Japan into the second technical timeout with momentum fully restored here. A one-on-one stuff block. Japan back in control of their fate here.
If you keep pushing, they make the mistakes.
Come on, 16 is already
Silva forehand there.
Solid take there. That's nicely played. Hishami Rice securing side out. Bring Ahmed Deo up to serve next for Egypt. It's going to work on looking for the first of the 3 points that they need here. Has done really well. Zakita picks off the cross court. Nishida, does it take a touch? No, is the answer. But Nishida thinks it did. Well, pretty simple. You don't go and complain about it. Challenge it. How they do. Well, that'll tell you something. The way all the Japanese players immediately said that took a touch. Is that no, that did not take a touch, but the reaction from the players was so insistent that Yuji Nakagaichi had to challenge that. It's been set back. Set that back. Interesting. Nothing doing for him. No, here comes trouble. No winner there for Saeed. With a cross court kill and the second time of asking. Spread himself, the veteran middle blocker comes off the bench with a wipeout. Rachido Mamoulin suddenly looks like a coaching genius. There's a point back. Just misses there. Wasn't far away from Hishami Weiss. So a couple of new players though, making a bit of impact here, and Egypt have not given up on this yet. They've got this one from here. That's a big mistake. They've got to maintain this level of intensity. And Nishida again searches in vain for another ace. Well, you've got four. It's getting greedy to look for any more, surely. Saeed. Kuzawa goes to the dink, picked up. Red all the way. Now, can they transition here? You bet. You bet. Dea runs on off the block. Suddenly, they're in the slipstream here. Now it's Japan that have to call a timeout. They chased 3 points, Egypt. They pull two of them back.
Wait a little bit for to go, huh? Sometimes we stay two, you can also have quick and five yards, huh? This is also important. If you can give the reception middle of the cross, it's much better for you, huh? Okay? Cool. You have 1 point contact. Make the side out, but you to go.
Hey, go! Well, Philippe Blaine, the voice of calm there, and Yuichi Nakagaichi knowing when it's time to say something and when to keep out of it. Kept his distance there. As Blaine just calmed everybody down. That wasn't a tactical talk. That was a psychological talk. Because Japan, from being comfortable, suddenly finding it tough going here. And there's still plenty of time for Egypt to secure this 1 point they need on serve. First order of business, get Said out of there for Japan. Said out. Well, they should do it from here. Nishida, oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Well, well, well. There is that point that they needed. That was an absolute shocker from the youngster. Now he is going to get taken out. Switch up of setter. Fuji comes in and it's Issei Otake. As Nishida will get a much needed breather. Got that last one all wrong. So, from cruising to a 3-1 victory, Japan suddenly find themselves staring at the real prospect now of being taken into a tiebreaker. Egypt recovering brilliantly here. Said stays on serve. Can they side out? Otake, make sure they do. Powerful hitter in his own right, Issei Otake. But they don't have a lead anymore. All they've got is front running in a side out battle. They need a point on serve. Fukuzawa conjured something up earlier. What can he find here? It's another good one. Sent back, but it's been somehow recycled here. That's not coming back. Driven through. Just look at that. Ahmed Said really wants this. Absolutely destroyed the block. Stay level. Rashad Atiya. It's not a great take from Yamamoto. And the block's there, but they can't keep it in. Ishikawa picks up another. Had his ups and downs in this match, Ishikawa. But he's kept going really well. He's now the top scorer in this one. Odira serving at 21-20. Can Japan find a point on serve? Well, that's a really nice take from Raider. This has to be a winner. And it is. Shirley Weiss rips that three. With it. So Masa Abdallah now up next. The setup. Really tense fourth set, this one. Fuji sends it back side, Otake rips it. That's the extra energy that Otake has brought in. That was an inspired switch up. Nishida is going to come back in now after that breather. But it's Fuji that sits down. Otake stays there. As they look for a block here, Japan. Oh. Otake's got a serve on him. That's a zinger. Really nice take from Saeed. And a miss. A big miss. Ishaki Weiss. Surely they've got to challenge this. They have to. I'm not sure they're going to get it overturned, but if the back of the ball has covered the edge of the line, that's all they need. Has it got a little bite of the sideline here? This could be the match. No. They're in trouble now. Peter Babula has to call his timeout here. It's his last one. Suddenly, after fighting their way back, they're on the edge again.
You can play quick, otherwise high. Middle five, yeah. You go quick motion, you decide middle five. Yes. Hey guys, head go. Yes. Hey, it's this time. Go. Yeah, guys,
Otake can find another big serve here. Japan could be looking at match point. For Egypt, it's side out, and then somehow find a point on serve from somewhere and quickly. Here comes Otake. Whoa, my goodness me, that is 20 meters, and I'm not exaggerating. That's 20 meters beyond the baseline. You won't see a longer one the whole of this World Cup. Oh, let's just say he lost that one. Egypt gets side out. It's a clever serve for Gayo. And it's sent back. Ishikawa takes Japan to match point. Everybody's on their feet. Yuki Ishikawa gets the honour of trying to serve this one out. Keep Japan's winning run going. Here we go. It's a net ripper. Sent back. Not going anywhere yet. Mohsen makes sure of that. They look defiant, Egypt. They're not going quietly. But this is still match point. Can Egypt defy the odds again? Not a big serve. Nishida gets blocked. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Saeed with the match-saving block. And I wonder if the Japan coaching staff are just questioning whether it was right to bring Nishida back in after he'd been blocked earlier and had that bad miss as well. He's still out there. Sakita's got to scramble around here. Fukuzawa can't find a winner. Saeed will go for something. Yamamoto's kept that alive. Nishida blocked again. Well, where's this going to go? Oh, my goodness me, they're hanging on by their fingernails here, Japan. Egypt with another chance. Saeed rips that. Sakita, brilliant. Nishida again, sends it way too long. Well, Yuji Nishida is having a real nightmare out there. Japan have to call a timeout. From match point, it's now set point, Egypt.
Okay. Remember, it doesn't push him forward, it pushes him back. You will make the next point, you will do. Just focus on. First, you focus on giving a reception, a good reception. Okay? First part, good reception. can cross this point. I think I can cross five, but you cannot.
There was absolutely no quit in Egypt these last couple of points. They want this. They really want it. If Japan want it, they're going to go out and earn it. They're going to have to. Still no change-up for Japan. They keep that same lineup out there. Mohsen then stays on serve. But this is Egypt serving for the set now. That's a roar of relief. What a wonderful rally this has been from Egypt. Yannick Eder comes in. Takahashi was out. Just listen to this atmosphere. They want it done in four, this crowd. Yanagida. With a beauty. Wonderfully picked up by Deo. Saeed. That's kept alive somehow. This is Hoist and Hope, though. Egypt containing this one. Hung up there, still no winner, yes it is. It sneaked through somehow. Set point again, Rashad somehow conjured something out of that. So, bringing Masahiro Yanagida in doesn't work for Yuichi Nakagaichi. Once again, Egypt serve this one out. Ishamini Weiss looking to take this into a tiebreaker. Not a good take at all. Fukuzawa's got problems here. Wonderful dig. Saeed off the block, kept alive, backcourt brilliantly. Fukuzawa keeps it alive. What a chance that was for Egypt. Boy, there's some serious high-level digging going on in these rallies. Just now has become two teams trying to impose their will on the other. They both want it and neither are going to give it up. Nishida sends a rocket in there. Raiders handled it really well. That's rubbed off the block nicely. Ishami Weiss maintaining this high level of efficiency that the Egyptians have now found. And it's Ahmed Saeed. Got a chance to serve this one out here to take us into a tiebreaker. Is this going to go back attack? Ishikawa rips it. This goes crazy. But all this is doing is keeping Japan in the set. They're doing the chasing. Even a point on serve. Just will force Egypt to chase. You'd still rather be in Egypt's position here. That's a sneaky one from Fukuzawa. Deo gets blocked, but the block spins away. Out of play. Set point again, Egypt. I wonder how much of this pressure Japan can stand. As Egypt are banging on this door. Rashad Atiyah then. Set point. Nervous. Yoshida has to come up with a big one. And does. Well, this is sweaty palms time, isn't it? 28 all. Vieira now serving. Egypt have to stay switched on here. They don't want the balance of power to shift here. Daniel's tail just stepped in front of that. Now, where's that going? It's staying in. Well, reset here. with another little dink on a deal to send that back. That's wonderful rescuing. Well, that's not coming back. Oh, despite Nishida almost getting it. It's set point again. Saeed coming up with an absolute beauty. Wow. What a drama here in this fourth set. Hossam Abdallah. Resetter. Looking to wrap it up here for Egypt. Zafida sends it over. Ishikawa's blocked out of it. And we are going all the way. We haven't seen too many blocks in this match. That is a block that could send Egypt back to winning ways. Mohsen absolutely wiped him out there. They wanted it. They really wanted it, Egypt. And they've got it. They earned it. An absolutely emotion-draining set for both sets of players, who will now have to pick themselves up and throw themselves into the tiebreaker, where it's just a sprint to 15. They've given themselves a chance here, Egypt, but they've got to just refocus now and say, job not done yet. Now we've got to move on and finish the job. What a wonderful fourth set that was. And Egypt fighting back from 3 points down. There haven't been many block points in this match, but that third block of that fourth set from Mohsen proved to be a set winner. Nothing to separate them on attack points. A couple of aces for Japan, but that third block proved to be decisive. Now, who can summon up the sinews here? Go for one big push. With a set like that, you often see a reaction from one team. Have just got to get the mindset right here. They've just given themselves a chance to push on and take this in five. And Japan, their mindset's got to be, okay, we haven't lost anything. Let's just go out and win it again. From being so close and having it snatched away, that's a sickener. Egypt fought so hard to level it up. Which way this tiebreaker's going to go is anybody's guess. I'm not sure too many people in this arena want this one to end. They are loving it. This is where you've got to play mistake-free volleyball. Make a mistake in the tiebreaker, you may not get a chance to redeem it. Zafida hangs one up there. Ishikawa rips one through there. This is how you want to start the tiebreaker. Absolutely ripping through the pipe attack there. Takahashi. good one. Really nice take from Teo. Oh, he's just missed. Just missed. He should be Rice. He'd love to challenge, but he knows he can't. So that was long. It's early, but Egypt can't afford another one like that. Takahashi missed. Side out. First of 15, remember. But, as with the first four sets, you've got to win by two clear points. Saeed sends that one in. Ishida picked up by Rader, who's got under that brilliantly. Teo gets blocked out. That was Ishida, I think. Wow. Well, he had such a rocky time. Indeed, it is. The teenager had such a rocky time at the end of that fourth set, and he's back in business now. And it's amazing how pumped up you can be off a stuffed block. Now, if he can stick an ace on here, Japan really will have this tiebreaker right where they want it. And he's always capable, and it's been a while since we've seen one. Not going to get one there. No nonsense. Very consistent hitter, Ahmed Deo. Rashad Atiya up next. Ishida, that's good enough to take on Moser, and Deo got the better of him. Just look at the penetration the block has got as well. And Ishida still found a way to get through. Now, Fukuzawa would love to conjure up another ace serve. There, nice take again from Deo. Backside it goes. Comfortable put away from Shaki Weiss. Side out. Hisham will serve. Serves Ishikawa. Attack doesn't work. Fukuzawa blocked. Sakita sends it over to Ishikawa. Deo picks that one up. Shutting him. Teammate out of the way there. Hassan Abdallah. Ishikawa, nothing doing again. Deo, now then, good chance here. Oh, that's picked up. Oh, this is a nervy rally this. Ishikawa, where's that going? Out of there. Two Egyptians absolutely sold out on that. Deo and Rader flew after that one. Neither of them would give it up. Neither of them could get there. That was a hard 4 point. Thank goodness both of them are okay as well. They both shot under and around the post. Could not keep it alive. That was a chance for Egypt. Japan wouldn't buckle. Oladera. Up next, Hossam Abdallah. He says it here. He's just trying to buy some time as much as anything. Egypt look to just reset here. This is not over, nowhere near over yet. But Egypt are chasing and they cannot afford that gap to grow now. Comfortable take. And even more comfortable put away for Mosin. We'll take him into double digits for the match. The biggest one, of course. Stuff block point. That brought an end to the fourth set. Let's produce this tiebreaker. Ahmed Deo, he's been very consistent for Egypt. serves Yamamoto. That'll be sent over to Ishikawa, and that's a block. Yamamoto is there. Ishikawa will have another go. That gets blocked. Go a third time, you bet, and then he's blocked again. Well, Hossam Abdallah was there to just wipe him out. Three goals he had. Every single one of them sent back. That was all Hossam. Just like that. Egypt get back level again. Brilliant, brilliant stuff this. Deo, five all. Nice pick up. Ishikawa's blocked again. It's blocked again. Same player, Hossam Abdallah, with the wipeout block. Read it perfectly. Look at this. Oh my goodness. All his own work again. The substitute is a switch up of setter. Sakita has just been feeding Ishikawa time after time after time. Goes back to the bullpen. Fujii comes in. Oh, where will he go? Here we go, Piper top. And look what happens. Fukuzawa with the put away. Fujii off the bench and straight into the hot seat. Fukuzawa celebrates the side out, but it's Fujii. He's back at the service line now. As we get ready to snap a six-all tie here in the tiebreaker. First to 15, remember. There's a big drop, that's Nishida again. Seeing some exceptional defensive play late in this match. And we may be here all night the way this one's going, because nine of these two are prepared to yield any ground at all. Fujii stays on serve. Raider picks that one up. Over it comes. Saeed will rub that off the block, and that isn't coming back. Side out. Level. 7-0. It's Mosin Dew up next. Yamamoto with the take. Fujii sends it inside. Takahashi can't get a winner though. Saeed will go for it. He gets blocked. That was a tough take. There's another tough take, and it's missed. Ishan. That wasn't an easy one. Look to try and send him down the line. Was it challenged? Which, admittedly, is on the far side, but that looks optimistic. Did any part of the side of that ball catch any part of the line? Oh, it did. It did. Oh, that's a big moment right there. Hishami Weiss looked over at his coach and said, you know what, I think that got a bit of the line, but he was right. That's a couple of millimetres. Stay on serve. Egypt front running now. Got to be side out for Japan. Their hopes of a podium finish are slim at best, but if they lose this match, those hopes will be over. And Egypt, who started off this competition with back-to-back wins, five defeats in a row. You wouldn't know it the way they're playing here. Baring their teeth, refusing to go quietly. amazing, turn it back in a couple of hours, how poor they were in that first set. They did finish it strongly, though. They got their wheels under themselves. Far too late to do anything about the first set, but everything has been fought for so hard. There's been very little to choose between the two of them. Ever since, Mosen then with serve. Context of the match, that is absolutely sensational, and no margin for error at all there, Ishikawa. That was a very missable shot. And if he had missed it, Ishikawa would suddenly have found themselves in control of this match. Can Ishikawa find an ace? Hasn't had one of those yet. Yamamoto's picked that up, but it's going to go and go and go. The quick set again does the damage. Sam doing all the sensible things. Egypt really blessed with two very, very good setters. Two very experienced, capable veterans. There is no big downgrade when they switch their setter. Ishida just too hot. Well, he hit a little rocky spell at the end of the fourth set. The coaching staff stayed with him. That's why. 45 points Ishikawa and Nishida have combined for Japan. And it could yet be in a losing cause. Takahashi, who's got a serve on him, sends that one in. That's trouble. Ahmed Said with the overpass. Fukuzawa pounced on it. Now, the balance of power shifts again. It's not a breakthrough, but Japan are front-running again. It's a lot easier front-running than chasing. Now Egypt have to side out. Takahashi with a ton of net cord there. Ripped away by Said. Ahmed Said just wanted to atone for that overpass. This is the last person Japan wanted to see on the end of the third touch, because he wasn't going to miss that one. They want to celebrate the Japan win here, but Egypt haven't read that script. Tough take. This is coming back. Now, what can they do? Can they regroup? Ishida. That's a tough take as well. Now they can plant, set, finish, deliver. Rashad Atiyah. Now it's Egypt front running again. Pure drama, this one.
Good. We have to continue to have some quick. Guys, to help, because they play a lot of quick, everything. It's number 9, it's pretty deep, around 6, so stay, take a different position a little bit like this. We have to take one or two defend on. I have this rotation.
You'll see better teams at this World Cup. You'll see better play at this World Cup. I'm not sure you'll see better drama. This is just a nail chewer. Every single one of these fans now in full voice, doing what they can to give Japan a lift, and Japan need that lift. This is another big moment. Ahmed Said serving. He has one ace. Another would really put Egypt in a strong position. Not going to happen. Nicely picked up. Where's that going to go? Hit with such speed. It span away and kept on going. Hossam Abdallah diverted that one a long way into the crowd. Side out. Nishida Both teams so close to the win here. It's one and over. Oh my goodness. The fifth ace. The balance of power shifts again. It's all that top spin he puts on. How often does that happen for him? Quite rightly, Peter Vermeulen has to say, just call a timeout here. That was just one of those breaks. All that does is have Japan front running. Change anything. So sit with that lead. Against them. They have to side out though. Well, you live by the net cord, you'll die by the net cord as well. Rashad Attia will go back. 12-12 in the tiebreaker. Easy bit away from Amadeira as a safe serve. Yeah, exactly what it deserves. We'll take Amadeira joining the double-digit club. There's a lot of players in that particular club at the moment. That's a crowded closet right now. Seven of them. Here's for Kuzawa, hoping to take Japan to match point. It's a soft one. They pick it up. It's blocked. No winner there for Hisham. Oh, the block comes back the other way! I think that was Nanobu Fuji, the little setter. He's got a bit of that. What a moment for him. Now it is match point. But Vermeulen has to call timeout here. Was all this effort from Egypt going to be in vain?
Yes, stay positive. Hey, break the
Japan
ball, play the ball.
Are on the
they
edge now.
The
nearly there. Egypt were here before, though, and they found a way back. They found a way back from this position in the fourth set.
Again, guys. Come on. Go.
But for Egypt, it's side out here. They have to win. The next point on serve. Exactly the same situation as they were in half an hour or so ago. Can they summon it up once more? Kuzawa then serving for the match. 14-12 Japan. Can Egypt fight it off again? Everybody on their feet. Kuzawa floats that in. Hold the celebrations. This is the moment of truth for Egypt. Ishandi Weiss has to make this serve good. Can they find another block here? Japan looking to set it up. No, Reina's picked it up. Oh, nervous times. This is coming back over. Oh, what a shame. What a shame for Egypt. They don't care in the crowd. And the Japanese players don't care either. That's such a sad way for this one to end. A breakdown in communications for Egypt. So all that work, all that effort in vain. And there's no sympathy for them at all. Not here in Hiroshima. Japan with a cliffhanger. What a match. You want to know what's good about this sport? Watch this one again. It had everything. Yuichi Nakagaichi is too tired to even smile. He's been on the roller coaster with his players. Spare a thought for Egypt, who kept on defying the odds, kept on finding ways to come back. They'd even got themselves into that last point. Just wasn't to be for them. You think back, the ace serve off the net court as well from Nishida. Wasn't meant to be for Egypt. Japan, and I'm sure Egypt, probably absolutely relieved. Tomorrow is an off day. There's going to be a lot of sore bodies in the morning. Nobody held back in that one. Everybody put everything on the line. One extra block, and that one ace serve proved the difference maker for Japan in that tiebreaker. 47 points in total between Ishikawa and Nishida. The two twin workhorses on the outside just kept going and going and going. Nishida, of course, with that fifth ace, ultimately helping them over the line. Seven aces for Japan, five of them from Nishida. The block, well, Egypt, of course, won that battle. We always expect Japan to lose there. And it wasn't a fatal flaw for them this time. Winning the attack point 75 to